advised.
Today I got an float. So just going to read for you what happened today morning. So I woke up. I tend to go to bed late. I work. So most times I work through the night. That's like when my brain is concentrating a lot. If you're a writer, you know what I'm talking about. I don't know why, but it's easier to write in the night. At 3 a.m. there, if you're not tired. So I always sleep. Well, earliest I wake up like at 8. Unless if I have a program. Or if a woman, if you're like a woman, you promise me like at 7 a.m. By 5 I'll be up. Anyway, that's besides the point, right? So I always wake up like at 8. So I wake up. I go to social media like every other human being. You know, those days whenever you would wake up, the first thing would be to, you know, first pray to God. That's for women. For men, when you wake up in the morning, you first touch your woman, you know, try to do a lot of kakuyege. So me, because I'm a single man, when I wake up, first thing I do, I go to social media, like most of you, right? And then there is a man who had posted something saying, anyone else notice Tumusime UG being a suck up all of a sudden? Has Museveni bought off all the influencers? Sad, petty, unfollowed. That one is actually true. I don't even yet have 10K followers on Twitter. I have like 9,000. Man, see? Retweet after retweet after retweet. He retweets events. He retweets even Museveni's breakfast. Now, the reason why this happened is, one day ago, I retweeted, Museveni had posted this. Lieutenant Col Paul Sanga, arrested in 1982 in Makindye. He escaped and returned to the bush. He lost his arm, where we were shelled by aircraft artillery at Chirema, over Kirema, Semuto. We carried him with his arm. Man, this is some Saving Private Ryan stuff. This is D-Day. This is Normandy. Man. They carried this guy and the arm which had been cut off by the shell. We carried him with his arm to the trench, and again, we were shelled while we stitched him. I salute you. This man survived, and he is here speaking in front of President Museveni without an arm. I retweeted that. Someone went to the bush to fight for the freedom of people. Forget the politics that has happened right now. In the 80s, got bombed twice. A shell cut off his hand, took him to a trench, and they shelled, they bombed them again. Museveni said it. I retweeted that. Previously, before that, I had retweeted something from President Museveni. Where is it? It's here. This is President Museveni. Find this article where I explain the importance of the Galamba Birembo trek and what exactly happened along this route as before the Liberation War. In case some of you have read this story, Museveni was not even partisan. He did not even say FDC. Actually, he just only mentioned Besigye and said that one day they were moving up a hill and Museveni fainted and let me just say that again because I'm confusing. Museveni was narrating a story of how they were trekking, their mission of fighting. And in that part, he said that there's a time when they were moving up a hill and he fainted and Kizza Besigye, that Dr. Besigye, gave him oral rehydration salt and he came back. Like Besigye helped him to gain consciousness again and be strong again and move up. So this thing, he doesn't mention Bobby Wine, he doesn't mention Besigye, he doesn't mention Votini, he just narrates a group of young men who were in the bush, moving, he says were bombed here, this one was leading here, this one went for peace talks and he was killed. He doesn't even say, oh, I'm a king. I retweeted that. Those two retweets got someone to tweet and say, let me read it for you again. Anyone else noticed Tumusime UG being a suck up all of a sudden? Has Museveni bought off all influencers? Sad, petty, and followed. Retweet after retweet after retweet. He even retweets Museveni's breakfast. Let me first introduce myself. My name is Tumusime. Oh, bomba glad man. The show is called The Unreliable Nonsense. I'm always here Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday from 8 up to 8:30 p.m. Yeah, now that that is out of the way, please follow me on my social media. Tumusime Separated. Tumusime on Facebook and on YouTube. Then on Twitter and on Instagram at Tumusime UG. Okay? Now let's go back to this. So now to make things worse, there is a bully on social media called Andrew Mwenda. So now I read to this guy. This guy called is called, I think, Smith or something. His handle is Sticky Blaze. Dude, that's so gay. Like, for a guy, I was supposed to say that one. Yeah. So he's at Sticky Blaze. I retweet him and I'm like, so I have been bought off by the NRM online now. I find that so ridiculous for anyone to say that I can be bought. Look at me. Do I look like a person who has been bought? Look at my hair. I last went to salon, I think, like 3 months back. I have growth. Sometimes we barely fuck and then piece of fucking guy's videos in number. You know? Look at my suit. I've been wearing this suit longer than man. Those of you who have been watching this show, you know that if, let's say, there was an accident and you found this quote, you know that my body is somewhere near there. I have been bought. So I found it ridiculous and I posted it with laughing emojis. Now Andrew Mwenda sees it. Now Andrew Mwenda comes out and he dresses the other guy. Please send me a share of the checks. Don't eat alone. Oh, man. Now, he shouldn't have said that, because when he said that, the gentleman came back and he was like, oh, my God, you tag all the powerful people you want. I know you're a public figure. You tag all the public figures, bitchy, but it does not change the fact that you people, you find this funny. The other guy said, I have unfollowed you. See, what, is this guy pregnant? Is he in a period? That's a sexist thing to say, by the way. You can't give those examples. Has his water broken? And our feminists have switched off as I came away. Several jira, but it's a joke. So, the guy unfollows me. Like, that can hurt me. Dude, there are very many things in my life that can actually hurt me than an unfollowing. Like, for instance, after here, there's a girl. She has promised me private parts. Not rape, no, like real. I've cancelled. In my heart. Now, you unfollow me and you think that can. Me? I'm a heart's boy. These things of Twitter don't even move me that much. So this guy unfollows me, and he's like, wait, and you know the reason I'm saying all this story, even before I jump into the story, it really shows you what has become of people in politics. You're too petty, you're too emotional. There's a guy called Myth, of course you know the Myth, he's a legendary rapper, like a revolutionary rapper with Clear Cut and then his solo career. He also presents a show here called Double Trouble on Saturdays. So Myth always disses me that I'm emotional. Has never been on social media looking at these people that support opposition. These are the real emotional people. Like, why would I retweet Museveni narrating a story of a guerrilla war, talking about shells and people's arms being amputated? And when I retweet that, you even break up with your wife. You're like, I'm pissed. I am done with everything in life. Even here, I married you by mistake. Get a hold of yourself. What's wrong with you? Oh, yeah. And those are the people that Bobi Wine appeals to. Because he knows that those are the only people that can actually support him. You can't appeal to someone who needs logic. You need a person like this, who's just emotional. What did I do? If Museveni says, I want to be president, vote for me, because I alone can run this country. And I retweet that. Now, that's a partisan retweet, right? Because I'm saying I endorse this message. Who knows, maybe I'll one day retweet it. If the figures are okay. But yeah, jokes aside, you know what I'm saying, right? How can I retweet a narration of an army guerrilla warfare? And then I'm a sack up from 70 now. How does that work? You people, you're too angry and you don't even know why you're angry and you don't know. You know Bobi Wine, that song that he sang, the people, they fear what they don't know and they don't know what they fear. Bombo clad, Katogo. Which I used to like, surprising. Like, I like Bobi Wine's music so much. Maybe people, if you are what you don't like, what's up with that, man? Anyway, you're too very. Let's continue with the show. I didn't come here to complain about myself. Well, it feels good putting myself in the show. Because it's John, and you're going to go Namulindwa. No. Did I just confuse Namulindwa with Full Figure? Oh, bruh, so they even tell me that I'm supposed to be breaking any time now. But before I go for the break, I'm just going to come back with this story of Full Figure. Full Figure was spreading her legs on social media. And everyone was like, oh my God, how did she do this? There's this chick called Farida Nakazibwe, you know, who was, the tabloid would say that she was involved in a Hooper war. Where did you guys get from? So you remember that she was fighting with a guy called, is it Namere? Well, this woman who was working here, right? Yeah, they were fighting apparently about maligning and defamation. Then the tabloids were like, Namiri and Farida involved in a Hooper war. It's like sexist, but funny, right? How am I do have a job on TV? Somebody's going to fire me one of these days. Well, yeah, say whatever comes in mind, right? So Farida Nakazibwe comes and posts a picture and is like, ew, such an ugly sight. That is an ugly sight. That is an ugly sight. Haven't you seen Winnie Nwaji? Like, you know, at the end of the day, right? Like, stop saying things because you're partisan. Come on. You all know that if this woman was supporting Bobi Wine and she did that in the middle of the road, and Janet Katam 7 said such an ugly sight, everyone would be like, oh, no, but did she? I want to let them enjoy. Then they start posting pictures. We to a swimming pool. I'm going to bikini. Although I'm not saying that Full Figure should do that, man. You know, because me, I was thinking, yo, man, blah. Full Figure, you have passed the age where you try to show us whatever it is between your sides, man. We're not interested in 70-year-old tease. That's not my short break. We shall be right back. Don't go anywhere.